Hi, my name is Angela Young, and today I want to talk to you about water dowsing and the important role it plays in not only farming, but society. Rob Thompson is a well-known dowser located in the heart of Sonoma Napa wine country. He's a third-generation dowser who co-owned one of the largest family-operated water well drilling companies.
Our family owns one of the largest water well drilling companies in Northern California. And my uncle's a very well-known dowser. And he came out when I was 10 years old to my dad's ranch in Santa Rosa, California. And he showed me how to douse. In fact, I started out dowsing with, he had a willow stick at the time, and he gave me these nylon rods, and this is called a forked dowsing rod. And so he walked around with him a day, and he found a few locations for water wells, but they were really far away from the home. And so it would cost a lot of money to develop with power and trenching and water lines. So my uncle said, "Hey, Rob, here, you play around with these for a week." And I walked around the whole ranch, just going all over the place. And I finally found something, you know, probably about 500 feet away from the house in this driveway portion. I found a big area. And so he came out the next weekend, my uncle did, and went over and he goes, "Oh my God, you did find something."
Wayne, my oldest brother, he was in the business. He was a super salesman, but he was also a well-renowned dowser, water witcher. He used the old willow stick. That was his favorite thing, was the willow stick. And he'd go out and find a green willow tree, and about once or twice a week, he'd pick out a few willow sticks. And that's just about every well we drilled was following his dowsing. And we had very, very high success in completion and getting water. So he built quite a reputation. The biggest share of water well drillers are small, family-owned, got one rig, the owner runs the rig, maybe hires a helper. And that's been the way the water well industry has been for, you know, centuries. And so on my dad, he was an entrepreneur. He just got into so many different, he was in the restaurant business, he was in the ice business. He and his brother, they came out on horseback from Colorado in the early 1900s. Bought out Weeks Hardware Store in Sebastopol in around 1947, I would say. He expanded in the early 50s into the drilling and pump business, which eventually became Weeks Drilling and Pump Company. We have retained the Weeks name because it was Weeks Hardware Store since 1906. He got involved in trying to find oil fields and gas fields, and he did it by dowsing. And he actually discovered oil in Redwood Valley. Then he went to Hollister, California. He put about several thousand acres on lease to get the oil and mineral rights, drilled a well there, found some good oil basin there, and wanted to finish the well off, but one of the major oil companies came in and basically sabotaged the hole through one of the subcontractors. Eventually, within 5 years, the majors moved in and developed quite a substantial oil field. At that time, he was still doing dowsing, and he found this area over in Pahrump Valley out of Las Vegas. He homesteaded 640 acres and drilled a well. He thought, this is good soil over here. He drilled a well, got an amazing 2,000 or 3,000 gallon minute well, and developed that, and then sold the property. And it now has become quite a major agricultural area out of Las Vegas because of the fact that the groundwater was there to water the plant. So again, through dowsing, that's what he did. He became also a map dowser, and he was able to discover fresh water on an island in the Caribbean where they had never been able to get fresh water. They had to haul their water in. And by map dowsing, he selected a site and they actually brought in water. So that's some of the amazing things that the dowsing industry has done. His son also was into dowsing, Greg. He yeah. did dowsing, and of course Rob is following suit, and he's
and Wayne taught me.
And Wayne, of course, yeah, you'd work with
me
Wayne.
Map dowsing. I did the same project in the Philippines.
Oh, okay. Water, fresh water, clean water around the world is a very, very sought after product because so many countries, older countries, my wife and I worked in Thailand for several weeks after the tsunami, and what we did was worked on trying to decontaminate wells, and practically every well there was contaminated. We don't have the problem here nearly like they do in foreign countries. You know, it's a tremendous problem. So the dowsing is obviously a family trait. Funny thing is, it never worked for me. It wouldn't work for me. It worked for Uncle Jerry. It worked for your dad. Sure. They didn't use it very often.
Actually, Chris, too.
Yeah, it works for Chris. It works for Chris's son-in-law, Brandon. He does it all the time now.
Oh, yeah.
But yeah, it never did work for me, but some people have the touch, a special touch.